Hi there again, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the 2U Dell PowerEdge R760 server. This is the big brother to the 1U PowerEdge R660 server we did a few weeks back, but just supports more storage and expansion options. Featuring the latest fourth generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs with up to 56 cores at the high end, you also get support for DDR5 memory and PCIe 5.0. It will also take two double-wide GPUs or up to six single-wide units, and offers optional direct cooling. There's also an impressive list of options for this platform. Let's take a look. The 2U Dell PowerEdge R760 server is definitely one of Dell's workhorse platforms. Featuring dual fourth generation processors, it can have up to 112 physical cores and 224 virtual threads thanks to Intel's hyperthreading technology. With support for DDR5 memory modules, PCIe 5.0 expansion slots, the R760 delivers some serious performance gains over the previous generation. Depending on the CPUs, storage, and addition of GPUs, it can support high-performance computing applications like AI, machine learning, general data center applications, virtualization and cloud, VDI and virtual desktop infrastructure, database analytics, and use as a software-defined storage node, just to name a few. I would have been somewhat concerned if it didn't support AI and machine learning. Seems like everything does these days. On a side note, do you think maybe with all the news articles about the government covering up UFOs, aliens, and crashed extraterrestrial vehicles and such, has any relationship to the push for AI and machine learning? Maybe it's not AI, but SI, you know, a silicon intelligence that we have to worry about, like how the Terminator T1 was replaced by the liquid metal T2. So now SI is trying to establish a foothold to take over the human race or clear the way for our cockroach overlords. That's just crazy talk. Would make a nice Netflix movie though. With twice the volume compared to the R660, there are a bunch of storage options for this system, not to mention more storage options for the back of the chassis. On the front, you can choose from 12 3.5-inch, 24 2.5-inch SAS, SATA, or third or fourth generation NVMe SSDs or HDDs. Of course, with that 24 2.5-inch bay option, there are also options with 8 and 16 bays. And that's where scalability comes in to add more storage up to 24 bays. Not mentioned in the technical guide, but definitely found in the spec sheet, is support for up to 16 NVMe E3.S drives. That would be the same number of EDSFF drives available on the R660. I was expecting more support on this system, but again, there are only a certain number of PCI lanes available, especially if you want to add some GPUs or high-performance NICs to the mix. That configuration will be released in the third, which is now, or fourth quarter this year. The E3.S drives will provide the highest storage density compared to the other alternatives. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R760 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. That's right. I don't know about you, but saving money is a great thing. When you are ready to make a purchase, all you have to do is mention that you watched this video. itcreations.com. Savings are just a click or a phone call away. Sorry, we don't have any tear-activated business cards. A control panel on the left supports the System Health and System ID button, but may also have an iDRAC QuickSync 2 wireless indicator for use with Dell's OpenManage mobile app. Or not. The OpenManage mobile app allows you to use an iOS or Android-based tablet or smartphone to access iDRAC for status, inventory, troubleshooting, remediation, and a number of other administrative tasks. Beside that, status LED indicators for drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe slots. On the other side, you get the power on button with LED indicator, USB 2.0 port, micro AB USB iDRAC direct port, which you might need if you don't go with the QuickSync 2 option on the other side, and a VGA port to connect a monitor should you desire a larger screen than your iPhone or tablet. Looking at the back, you can see the PSUs stacked to either side of the chassis. There is a range of PSUs options depending on how the system is configured. Hot swap PSUs at the low end can provide up to 700 watts, all the way up to 2800 watts at the high end, and various levels in between. We have the 1400 watt PSU installed on this system. The back of the server can be outfitted with additional storage options too. Choose from 2.5 inch, 2 and 4 bay drive cage options. Ours has a minimal configuration with blanks in the place of the PCIe slots just above each of the PSUs, corresponding to riser 1 and riser 4. In that middle section, riser 2 is on the bottom and riser 3 is on top. In total, the system is capable of supporting up to 8 PCIe slots, but we'll get to those in a minute. Along the bottom between the PSUs, there is an I/O board that can be removed and replaced if need be. It has a system identification button with integrated LED light, one RJ45 port to access the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller for remote management of the system, two USB ports with one USB 2.0 and one USB 3.0, plus a VGA port. If this system was equipped with liquid cooling, then the tubes would be exiting right where that VGA port is located. An OCP 3.0 card slot in the middle provides more options for network interface controllers, or NICs, that won't use up any of those PCIe slots. Ours has dual SFP28 transceiver slots offering 25 gigabit Ethernet. Next to the PSU on the left is another slot for an optional LAN on motherboard circuit board with two NIC ports. That connects directly to the system board. One more thing, there is an optional boot device located in the Riser 1 carriage that supports either one or two M.2 drives. iDRAC 9.0 Express comes standard on this system. However, the system can be upgraded to support Data Center, Enterprise, or Enterprise Advanced, which offer additional features to manage the system. Of course, there is an additional licensing fee associated with the enhanced management features. If you are interested in some of the features, check out our iDRAC video with iDRAC 9 Enterprise. I placed a link in the description below. Dell's OpenManage is also an option for multiple servers and comes in several licensing levels too. Not to mention the Dell OpenManage mobile app, which will connect with the optional OpenManage QuickSync 2 module on the front of the chassis. With the cover removed, you can see that boot device in Riser 1. The Boss-N1 monolithic controller can support dual 480GB NVMe M.2 drives that support RAIDs of 0 and 1 and is specifically used to boot the system. The unit has a PCIe Gen 3x4 host interface. The M.2 drive caddies are accessible from the back of the chassis for easy replacement in the event one of them goes south. We only have one drive for this unit with a blank in the other slot. For those with one drive, you can use RAID 0. Nope, not going into how that works with one drive, but with two drives, you can use RAID 1 for mirroring. There are no additional PCIe slots in our specific riser or lack of riser, but there are optional risers available with two slots corresponding to slots 1 and 2 on the back of the chassis. Riser 2 goes just underneath riser 3 in the middle, with riser 4 above the other PSU. We also have a standard air shroud directing fresh air over the CPUs and memory module slots from just behind the fans, then out the back through the PCIe slots. There is another air shroud for GPUs plus three different fan types depending on how the system is configured. Gold VHP fans are recommended for systems outfitted with optional GPUs. A full kit for installing GPUs includes gold fans, a different fan shroud, heat sinks, and specific risers. Several NVIDIA GPUs are supported on this system, including the A2, A30, A40, A16, A100, A800, and H100. Only the entry-level A2 doesn't require any additional cables. That one only draws 40 to 60 watts and can be powered directly from the PCIe slots. The others require an 8-pin cable or 12-pin cable if installing those H100 GPUs. The H100 is definitely not an entry-level card and is designed for AI training applications, like AI chatbox and AI recommendation engines that anticipate your needs. Creepy, but useful in a business. Removing the air shroud exposes the CPUs with heat sinks and 36 memory module slots. If this system had direct cooling, DLC, you would see tubes coming in from under riser 4 and connecting with the two CPUs. Each of the CPUs have 16 memory module slots. With 12 memory channel architecture, two DDR5 DIMMs can be loaded in per channel. Supported DIMMs include registered ECC DDR5 modules with a memory speed of up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. CPUs with up to 56 cores and a thermal design power rating of up to 350 watts are supported. We have dual fourth generation Intel Xeon Scalable Silver 4410Y 12-core processors installed in this system with a TDP of 150 watts and 30 megabytes of cache. With a Y suffix on the end of that product number, this CPU features Intel's Speed Select Technology, or SST, and is optimized for general workloads. Surprise! Other suffixes include H for database and analytics, M for AI and media processing workloads, N for networks, 5G, and edge computing, and P CPUs, which are optimized for infrastructure as a service, or IaaS, cloud high-frequency virtual machine environments. There are a few more, including S, which is for storage and includes full accelerators enabled. Intel's fourth generation CPUs have integrated accelerators, which is something that AMD has not added to their EPYC CPUs just yet. Additional options include an internal USB card or micro SD card module that can be installed in a dedicated connector on the system board. Those aren't nearly as effective as a BOSS though. If you will be installing SAS drives or simply want the ability to create a RAID beyond that provided by the integrated RAID controller, then you will need a PowerEdge RAID controller or PERC. There is a PERC for that PCIe slots and also a front PERC that mounts at the front of the chassis just behind the backplane. Dell's 12th generation PERC cards provide RAID options for both SAS and NVMe drive types at 24 gigabits per second, or twice as fast as the 11th generation PERC controllers. That OCP card is an optional feature and will provide a maximum port speed of up to 100 gigabit Ethernet and a maximum of 4 ports. By the way, that max port speed is combined. In other words, a single 100 gigabit Ethernet port and 4 ports, each with a 25 gigabit Ethernet connection. There are a number of port options to choose from, and these are especially useful if you have other plans for the PCIe slots, like additional hard drives, GPUs, maybe a PERC, or some other high-speed network interface controllers. Clearly, there are a lot of options for the Dell PowerEdge R760 server. I mean, it is a general purpose server, but I always make fun of the fact that some manufacturers have a different SKU and a slightly different name for the system when they change one minor aspect, like integrated dual 10 gigabit Ethernet ports instead of dual 1 gigabit Ethernet ports. Dell turns this concept on its head by providing the same platform with tons of options. Sure, there are still a few different SKUs to make purchasing something closer to what you want easier, but in the end, it is still the Dell PowerEdge R760 server. If you found this video useful, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button. In fact, we just got a dual socket Dell PowerEdge R7625 with fourth generation AMD EPICs that will definitely be sharing a video of that one in a few weeks. If you have any questions on this one or any other server, then post them in the comments section below. We do actually read them and respond. Looking for this server or perhaps some parts? Click one of those links right there or check out itcreations.com. Chances are we have what you need at a great price. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.